صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم
was a guide for our people and a mercy to the universe was a guide for all people God's peace and blessings on him
Sallallahu ala Muhammad Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه اللهم افتح لنا أبواب حكمتك وانشر علينا خزائن علمك اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا إنك على كل شيء قدير I salute you all with a salutation of peace السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته First of all I'd like to thank you and to sincerely thank you for making it tonight To spare some of your time for the topic is a topical one and I'm sure we are all interested on how to cope with the current situation. We'd like also to thank our visitors who are visiting Oman from the United States. We have students who are here with us, about 17 of them I think, or close to that number. We do have also professors from Greek or from Greece who are also interested to know more about the current events. And lastly, we had visitors from other countries, including Norway. To make sure that the topic tonight and the discussion is going to be a pleasant one, I would first please urge you all to reach your pocket or your purse and make sure the gadget you have in your pocket called a destructive tool, a mobile that is on silent or is totally switched off. Every time it goes on, I'll dance. And if I dance, you won't like it. Yeah, mine is off. Please, you have 30 seconds. Reach your pocket or your purse. If I don't dance, I'll find you, and I'm going to take it as a gift. Without paying the bills. Okay. Considering that the number is too big, we'll try to engage everyone. Through that, I think everybody will get a chance to participate one way or the other. If you can't find a place, please, the floor is still clean, and make yourself comfortable. I think Muslims have recently been tested on their faith, on their love for their faith. They've been tested on legitimacy of loving the Prophet, peace be upon him, as well as respecting the religion. The reaction was overwhelming and probably went beyond the call of duty. And whether that brought the necessary reaction and the desired outcome, or whether the outcome was contrary to that, time will tell. Nevertheless, as Muslims, we are here on a purpose, we are here on a mission, and we are living for the ultimate cause. And there are times when events do happen, many tend to forget the purpose, many tend to forget the essence of their existence, many tend to forget on the etiquette that Islam calls for in dealing with self, dealing with others, or even dealing with Almighty Allah. So tonight I'm going to throw some questions to try and gauge where we all fit. I'll be provoking you and I'll be challenging you to challenge yourself. So I'll be provoking your thinking, your thoughts. I'll be asking some questions that are probably very sensitive. And because you're also others who are interested in understanding Muslims who have other beliefs, we'd like to hear from them as well. So let us establish a dialogue of trying to understand the issue. And before we conclude, we'd like to leave here with some resolutions on how we can make this world a better place to be. How each one of us can be an effective member. Each one of us can be an influencing factor in trying to either understand each other or understand ourselves, for that matter. So the first question is a very simple one. The first one is very simple. Why do you think the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was portrayed in the papers, in those cartoons, as it was? And you have 30 seconds to think of an answer. Why do you think? And I'm going to take only but maybe 4 answers here and 4 answers there, and we'll move on. We all know what happened, but why did it happen? Any volunteers?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Maybe those people who have been ruled as this cartoons, they think that Muslims won't react to it.
Okay. Maybe they thought Muslims won't react to it. It was the freedom of
speech.
Of expression. Okay, that is one answer. At the back? Okay, probably there's a propaganda behind this to go deeper into the core values of Muslims. Maybe to test the level of tolerance amongst Muslims. Are they tolerant? Okay, that's the third one.
Part of the way Western culture works is to make fun of things they don't understand, and that they're maybe, since they're misunderstanding, they are worried or anxious about, so.
Okay, part of the Western culture is, of course, is to express themselves and in trying to understand others. Okay? Any other offer? Yeah, in the back? Good question. Says, we do not follow him. How can you protect him? Again, it's testing Muslims themselves in their own understanding of their faith and belief. Okay? Okay, so there you have your 2 answers. One of them is that it's the media that portrays Muslims as either violent, terrorists, bad people. At the same time, it's the way some Muslims behave in the name of Islam. So give 2 answers. 2 more?
Yeah.
No, you use the answer. You don't have the chance.
I think it's mainly due to ignorance of European people.
Okay. The ignorance of the West towards Islam, what matters to them, what does matter, in other words, what matters to Muslims? Final one?
They are Muslims, so they don't understand what is Muslim's message, what is
okay. They are relying on a misguided source. There is no credible source for them to refer to. And I think from this, we have already established the grounds of tonight. That is what has happened. Now let us reflect inwardly. Us as Muslims, did we have a contribution element towards this? Were we the cause? And I think I've heard some of the answers, but I'd like to become crystal clear now. If we reflect on ourselves, did we play a part in this? Whether they were reacted or whether the Muhammad peace be upon him was portrayed?
Yes.
Are we part of the problem? If I can use the word problem. I hear the word yes. Let us have a vote. Because we are the majority here. Who says we are part of the problem? Okay, I could see about 10, 20, 25%. From the ladies, I think about 1%, 3%. Okay? So, very few of you think that we are part of the problem, or we are the cause of that problem. And that is an interesting observation. So let me ask another question. Why do we love the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him? Why such a reaction? Why such an emotional reaction towards Muhammad?
It's a part of our faith.
It's part of our faith. We love him. We portray that we love him. Yeah? And indeed, we have to love him as well as love all other prophets.